a golden ring. It is a twisted string, and you can ask the counselor, and you can ask the king, and I'll say the same thing. And it's a funny thing. Should we go outside? Should we go outside? Should we bake some bread? I am interested.
She can answer any question about plots to do with love. Like, I can ask her anything, and the thing is, she doesn't know she's answering, but it's clear. She goes into a fugue state and then answers. I'll be like, so if I wanted to structure my novel this way and have these two people get together in this way, then what should happen here? And she'll tell you, and then, like, it's clear she's woken up from the fugue and be like, what did I say? It's really weird.
When you brought Victorian London alive for me in a way that, say, Dickens never did, which is, you know,
now we're distracted by that. In the world of instruments, you included a forbidden love. What made you want to include something
not forbidden?
I mean, because it wasn't forbidden. I thought that it was super exciting. I thought that a lot of times we get forbidden love and it's like two people whose love is forbidden because one of them is allergic to peanuts and the other one isn't. I wanted to be really forbidden. These people really can't.